Hey everyone, Haley here, social growth marketer at Biteable. Today, I'm teaching you how to edit your Zoom recordings. Let's get started. So here I am in my Zoom meeting. To go ahead and get started with the recording, I'm just going to select record along this bottom timeline here. This will notify all of the participants that the meeting is being recorded. You can use the pause and stop controls along the bottom timeline to control your recording, and then once you're finished, go ahead and click end. If you're finishing the entire meeting and you click end meeting for all, this will automatically prompt your recording to begin downloading. Then you'll get this pop-up with all of your different files here. You have an audio only file and a video file, and the video file is what we're going to be focusing on. So I like to drag the video file to my desktop so I have easy access to it so I can re-upload it into Biteable. Then you'll jump on over to biteable.com, and from there you can go ahead and log into your account or create an account if you don't have one yet. From here you can go ahead and click start with an empty video, and then you'll be prompted to choose your video shape based on where you'll be uploading the finished video. So I'm using this one for social media, so I'll pick a 1:1 or 16:9 depending on what social network I'm uploading to. This screen is where you'll really get to build out your video and make your Zoom recording extra exciting. So we have these different folders of animations here. You can scroll down and choose. We have a folder specifically for team communications, which is great for these Zoom recordings. As you can see, all of these different folders are great and they're well organized, so you can find just what you're looking for. So I'll head over into the intro and outros folder. This is a great spot to kind of add a beginning scene and an end scene to your recording and make it look very cohesive. And then I'll just go ahead and start picking the scenes that I want to appear in my video. It doesn't have to be in the right order right now. We can rearrange the scenes later on. Once you've found those scenes you like, just go ahead and start clicking and you'll see them automatically add to our timeline in the bottom there. Then I'm going to go over and head to the upload page. This is where I'll drag in that Zoom recording that I took from a previous meeting. And once it loads, it'll appear in the timeline. And I'm just going to rearrange where my scenes are here. So I'm going to click and drag that Zoom recording right into the middle scene. So now I have an intro, my Zoom recording, and an outro. I'm going to turn the custom watermark feature on to really brand my video. Just kind of adds that extra touch. So you can go ahead and upload your logo to the watermark area. This is what it looks like with the Biteable logo. And then you can resize and reposition that too. So starting with our intro scene, I'm going to go ahead and start customizing this video. This is where I'll put maybe the title of the meeting. You can also change all of the animation colors and the background colors so they're more cohesive with your brand. So it's as simple as choosing from our color palette, or you can enter in your own hex code as well. I'm also going to change the color of the font just so it matches a bit better with my new blue color scheme. Jumping over into our meeting recap video here, I'm going to delete the caption box that was automatically added, and I'll do that by clicking the trash can. Here you can see we've got a pretty long Zoom recording. Most of it will be either very important, and there's probably going to be a bit of fluff at the beginning and end too. So as you can see, there's audio attached as indicated in the timeline, and I can choose whether I want that audio to fade in or fade out, or I can also turn those features off by clicking on those volume bars. You'll also have complete control over the upload with audio volume. You can turn the volume of your recording all the way up, or you can also turn it down too. You can use the placement feature to control the size of your Zoom recording. So if you wanted it to be a bit smaller on the screen, you have the power to do that as well. And then you can go ahead and click on trim footage if you have bits at the beginning and end that you'd like to remove from your video. Just use the slider bar here to trim out any unnecessary parts. Now that we've trimmed the footage that we didn't need from our video, I'm going to go ahead and head over to our end scene here. Again, you can upload your logo if you'd like. You can pop in a website or a call to action. So this is where I'll add my call to action for the rest of my team. Just letting them know they can watch the full recording in Slack. Again, we'll change these text colors so they match all of the changes that we made in our intro scene. And we're getting close to the end here. You can use these scene transition buttons to choose which transitions take place in between all of your scenes. As you can see, we've got about a dozen different scene transitions to choose from. I'll just go ahead and pop those in between each scene. And you can also click on this soundtrack icon. This will let you choose a background music track, or you can upload your own if you have that as well. We have over 80 different music tracks to choose from in Biteable. So we'll go ahead and click save. The great thing about this is your background music will automatically be quieter during the scenes where you have a video that has its own audio. So our background music will automatically get a little bit quieter during our Zoom recording, and then it'll increase in volume during the intro and outro scenes. Let's watch our video.
This is obviously a serious meeting conversation that we're having. We're probably gonna have to discuss some action points, and then we'll have to-dos, and then we'll probably rectify some of the serious things that need rectification. And did you have anything else you wanted to add to the agenda for this meeting?
I think that sounds like a great agenda.
Okay, well, let's start with the to-dos from the last meeting. Did you do the things that needed to be done?
I sure did. Did you?
No, but because okay. I lost the list.
That's okay.
But we'll make let's add that as the first item for this meeting, is that we make the to-do list of things to do that weren't done from the last meeting.
That's perfect. And we can circle on that to-do list in the next meeting.
That sounds perfect. Great. Now, I just want to check in. 26-year-olds, are they okay?
We're struggling. As reported in the Detroit News, we are struggling.
Yeah. Is it the exclamation marks? Is that the heart of the problem?
You know, it's the exclamation marks. But I think there were some other things in that article too. Quite a few 26-year-olds were related. 2.5 million to be exact.
That's a lot of 26. That's a lot of angst, isn't it?
And once you're happy with your finished video, if you wanted to make any changes, any more footage trims, you can do that after you've previewed it. So I'll just shrink this scene down a little bit since we trimmed out some footage. And then I'll head over to the export tab. This is where I can start the build process for my video. Once that's completed, I'll be able to download my video or share it with a link. And if you share with a link, then you'll have access to Biteable Analytics, which gives you information like total views, engagement, and locations of your viewers. One thing to know with our Zoom recording editing is a paid Biteable plan is required to upload footage with audio. If you're on a free Biteable plan and you upload footage with audio, your video will automatically be muted. So here, if you go to biteable.com/pricing, you'll be able to view all of the different Biteable plans. Both our Plus plan and our Ultimate plan will give you access to uploading footage with audio. And if you scroll down, you'll be able to see a comparison table that goes down what exactly is in every plan and what the benefits are over the Ultimate plan compared to the Plus plan and so on. So you can go ahead and check that out at biteable.com/pricing. And there you have it. If you're ready to start editing, head over to biteable.com to get started. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to our channel down below for more videos just like this. Bye.